Over the last few days, we've done a lot of work with the gas laws. So what we're going to do now is apply those gas laws along with the old concept from weeks ago, stoichiometry, to solve some problems involving chemical reactions with a gas. And we've got one right here. Let's take a look at it. Carbon monoxide reacts with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide. So we'll have to write the equation in a moment and make sure that we balance that. And then the question stipulates quantities here. If 1 liter of carbon monoxide reacts with oxygen at STP, and we can write that down in a moment, we have to remember what STP represents, we're faced with two questions. A, how many liters of oxygen are required to react? And B, how many liters of carbon dioxide are produced? So let's gather our information, list it in an organized fashion, and then proceed from there. So I've got you started here. I've written the formulas for the participants in the reaction. We've got our carbon monoxide reacting with our oxygen gas, yielding carbon dioxide. So I'll pause the video. You take a moment and balance this particular equation. And then, while the video is still paused, continue on and write along the left-hand side here all of the data that you have available to you. So I've listed the crucial information. Let's take a look at it. We've copied down the temperature here, 273 Kelvin. That is standard temperature and standard pressure. We have here 101.3 kPa. As stated in the question, we have 1 liter of carbon monoxide. And I'm sorry, I forgot to write down that was our carbon monoxide. And then we need to remember that the molar volume of any gas at STP is 22.4 liters. This is a very important relationship for gases. Just remember, it is only true if our gas is at standard temperature and pressure, which happens to be the case in this problem. So let's take a look at our first question here. Part A. How many liters of oxygen are required to react? Well, we know the quantity of carbon monoxide is 1 liter. And we know that we have 2 moles of carbon monoxide reacting with 1 mole of oxygen gas. In addition, we have down here our molar volume equality. See if you can use those pieces of information and set up an equation for part A. I'll pause the video and you try to solve that problem. So let's take a close look at how I've set this problem up and follow our rules of dimensional analysis. We start with our 1 liter of carbon monoxide. Now we know we're trying to get to liters of oxygen, but we have a few steps involved to get there. To start, we need to get our unit liters of carbon monoxide to disappear. So we use our molar volume ratio as a dimensional analysis quantity. 1 mole of carbon monoxide is 22.4 liters of carbon monoxide if we're at standard temperature and pressure. So consequently, we can set that up as a conversion factor and divide out our liters of carbon monoxide. Next, we use the mole ratio from the balanced equation. 2 moles of carbon monoxide for every 1 mole of oxygen gas. We set it up accordingly so that we get moles of carbon monoxide to divide out. Make sure you don't cross off your 2 there. And likewise, we're trying to return to liters of oxygen. So we need moles of oxygen to divide out. Again, we use our 22.4 liters of a gas per mole of that gas. Now notice, since we use that conversion factor twice, we can go ahead and cross off our 22.4 as well. And we'll end up with just liters of oxygen for our final answer. Calculator takes care of the rest. So I'll pause, you calculate, and we'll check our answers. And if you arrived at the answer 11.2 liters of oxygen, you have the correct answer. And a quick review of how we solved that problem. We carefully read the statement. We knew we needed a balanced chemical equation. We listed all of our variables. And then we applied dimensional analysis technique to arrive at our final answer.